Mr. Speaker, I recognize that this is an extraordinary motion, but we are living in extraordinary times. Yesterday in Uvalde, Texas, a gunman massacred 19 young children, most around the age of 10 years old, and two teachers in their elementary school in the deadliest school shooting since Sandy Hook in 2012. Mr. Speaker, I understand that the debate must be limited to the motion to suspend the rules, but I ask for some latitude to discuss the senseless gun violence that has become our nation's collective nightmare and how that violence gives rise to the need for this extraordinary motion. Mr. Speaker, we must suspend the rules and act now because we have the power and the moral obligation to act today before this happens one more time. Mr. Speaker, we must suspend the rules and act now because in shootings like the one yesterday in Uvalde, Texas, they are not just picking up little bodies and laying them in angelic satin-lined coffins for peaceful rest. They are scraping up the bodies of children, elementary school children, who need to be identified by their clothing or their dental records or their DNA off of blood-covered floors because their bodies and faces have been rendered unrecognizable by an assault weapon in the hands of an 18-year-old. Mr. Speaker, we must suspend the rules and act now to advance House Bill 770, a bill that would ban any future sale of assault weapons because these weapons are designed to kill as many people as possible, as quickly and violently as possible. Mr. Speaker, we must suspend the rules and act now because the data reflects that more than 95% of public mass shootings resulting in four or more deaths were caused by an assault rifle. Mr. Speaker, we must suspend the rules and act now because an assailant with an assault rifle can hurt and kill twice the number of people compared to an assailant with a non-assault rifle or handgun. The statistics I cited here are not politically motivated. They come from the Journal of Trauma and Acute Care Surgery and the Journal of the American Medical Association. Mr. Speaker, no single legislative action is going to end America's gun violence problem, but we need to take every action that we can. Study after study has found that the 1994 federal assault weapons ban was effective at reducing crime and getting deadly military-style weapons off of the street. Mr. Speaker, we must suspend the rules and act now because today in Texas, parents are lined up to provide DNA to positively identify their children because their children have been mutilated beyond recognition by assault weapons. Mr. Speaker, we must suspend the rules and act now because in the first 144 days of 2022, this country has experienced 214 mass shootings. 214. Please join me in voting to suspend the rules to bring up House Bill 770 and acting now on gun violence in Pennsylvania.